So sticking with the government theme, we're going to talk about government reference architecture now. And to do that, it's a pleasure to introduce Juan Pablo Revello, who is the Chief Solutions Architect at AGESIC, which is the Agency for E-Government and Information Society in Uruguay. As a computer engineer, Juan specialized in information systems and data management technology. And as AGESIC's Chief Solutions Architect, he leads a team of architects and who are responsible for the enterprise architecture of the Uruguayan e-government platform. So it's a big job, and hopefully a big warm welcome for Juan Pablo Revello. Welcome, Juan.
Hello to everyone. Thank you, Steve, for the introduction and the presentation. I want to talk about our experience and our work with enterprise architecture, especially with the TOGAF framework. I think you have my slide over there.
Juan, before you get started, can you turn up your volume a bit?
Okay.
You're quite quiet, Juan. If you can get closer to the microphone or speak a bit louder, that would work. And you can control the slide. So if you click on the slide deck with your cursor, you'll then be able to move the slides yourself by using the up and down arrows to the left of the slides.
Yes, thank you. Can you listen to me now? It's better?
It's a little bit better. Obviously, attendees can turn up their volume, but if you could speak a bit louder, that would be helpful. Thank you.
Okay, I will speak louder because the volume is at top. So I don't know what's happening. Okay, I move on.
There you go.
Okay, the agenda for my presentation is first a brief introduction to Uruguay Digital to set the context and the development of the country in digital services. Then how we started with enterprise architecture, with the digital service architecture. Then the integrated government architecture we built and the architecture community we developed for the government. And finally, the next steps. Okay, I have a short video here, but I will share you the link in the chat so you can watch it later. After my presentation, so we avoid problems with the audio. Okay, so I view the main concept of the video. Uruguay is a global leader in the use of digital technologies and has become a regional and global benchmark of digital and open government in transparency and democracy. Uruguay is a member of Digital Nations, a group of the most advanced digital countries. Digital Nations is a collaborative network of the world's leading digital governments with a common goal of enhancing digital technology to improve citizen lives. AGESIC provides innovative digital services that make life easier for its citizens, and is one of the most advanced and egalitarian societies in digital development. In more than 10 years of digital government, Uruguay has positioned itself at the forefront as a regional and global benchmark in digital development. This is demonstrated by the indicators and also by the experiences that have been taken as an example and model, such as the digital inclusion of children and old adults with their own computer and tablet, livestock traceability, digital services, the digital medical records, and the digital signature for the entire population. It's about using technology as a means to guarantee the digital rights of digital citizenship. So you can check out the video after I finish my presentation. That has a nice summary of our development. Okay. One of the main goals we have started with enterprise architecture, in particular with the TOGAF application, is that at the end of the previous government term in 2020 was that all the public services should be available online. In Uruguay, as in many South American countries, each public organization has a different maturity level and development and knowledge of the use of IT. So we have some organizations with well-built and solid IT areas, and on the other hand, we have a lot of organizations that only have an IT department for near a home or domestic support. So when we started, we didn't know even how many digital services we had in the government. We can convince that to carry out this initiative efficiently and optimally, it was necessary to have a different approach than digitize one by one. So we began to model the different types of digital services, finding patterns by category and shared assets. So the objectives we said were that we need to have an integrated vision, we need to order the chaos, find a common language between IT and business and between public and private organizations. We want to take the next step from interoperability to integration and promote an efficient use of IT resources in the government. So at this point, we start to study the enterprise architecture framework. We select the TOGAF standard for establish an architecture that guides public organizations in the design of technology infrastructure, databases, applications, and in the use of information systems. This architecture was built based on TOGAF standard, allowing a unified view of the architectures of the technological solutions that support the digital services. To clarify this framework, this digital service architecture, I will give you some examples of definitions of solutions for each domain. Starting with business domain, we want to align the objectives of the organization with the purpose of the digital service. Not all the digital service has a main purpose for IT. So we want to have this alignment. We also specify the standard for modeling the services with BBMM notation 2.0. And talking about information systems or application and data domain, we promote the adoption of BBM solutions and we generalize solutions for the entire government, like a single sign-on government solution that gives one user for all public organizations. We realize that a lot of digital services must have a payment gateway, so we build one, and a traceability solution that makes transparency for citizens that allow the user to know the steps of their services. We also build a unique digital service catalog. Going to the technologic domain, we already had a suite of technological solutions, such as a technical and level interoperability framework, a private optical fiber network called UI that connects all the public agencies, and a government cloud where we bring software as a service, platform as a service, and infrastructure as a service. We add two more domains to the framework that are security and performance, and especially in security, we enforce the adoption of digital signature and digital identity in the development of the digital services, and try to convince of the importance of personal data protection, that we have many laws about this topic, but we want to convince from this domain for the public organization. So at this point, we build the framework for digital service architecture that allow us to have an overview of all the government and one enterprise, and we realized that was really a success for the main goal that we have to achieve. So we want to generalize this experience, and we build an architectural framework called the integrated e-government architecture, like as a standard tailoring, the TOGAF standard tailoring. We add a regulatory framework to the general principles and two cross-cutting domains that are security and performance. We want to apply the framework in other strategic domains, and to be a reference for private organizations to build their own architectures. The content of the framework is first a general architectural vision, then the legal framework inside the general principles, and we have a reference model for each TOGAF domain, including the new ones, security and performance. And for each model, we have directives, recommendations, guidance, best practices, standards, and products. About the new domains, first of all, security. We already have a cybersecurity framework, and it was a good way for integrate with other domains. And in performance, we want to promote the measurement of results and performance for the different domains and the different goals of each organization. In this slide, we can see the complete vision of the framework. On the left side, we have an integrated e-government architecture, which is the TOGAF tailoring with the reference models and the continuum and the continuous development and the repository. On the right side, we have the interoperability reference architecture, like we call this a strategic domain architecture. We have the digital service reference architecture that I already talked about. We have another about geospatial data reference architecture and the e-health reference architecture. We now are working in building an educational reference architecture. I want to talk about the e-health reference architecture that provides an overview of how the e-health national record platform is developed. We have the entire ecosystem and the model for each framework domain with its necessary specifications to be part of the platform. This architecture allows a new hospital or health institution in the country to understand how the e-health national record solution works and to see what things they have to develop to be part of the ecosystem. Having the health reference architecture was an advantage last year when we had to create the COVID application for traceability of the infected people. We quickly connect the application with the old hospital and private institutions through the e-health platform. And finally, in the bottom, we have the different public organizations that build their own reference architecture based on the e-government architecture framework. Going on with the repository, we have the Knowledge Center. The Knowledge Center is a public wiki where we document and share all our work. We have now two knowledge centers, one for interoperability, another for enterprise architecture, where is all the documents about the integrated e-government architecture framework. We also have the building blocks. Here we add a new concept of building blocks that are the data building blocks. We call data building blocks such as vocabularies, metadata, referential data, and open data. Open data an independent initiative in the country, and we link to this building block to have a complete vision of the data organization. The architecture building blocks have the integrated architectures, architectures pattern, and IT reference architecture. And in the solution building blocks, we have solutions that the agency brings like as a service, and the public software initiative that already exists, but we also link for this for this domain and to have the complete vision. About the continuous, we want to improve the process of construction of the reference architecture. We receive feedback about the repository, the framework itself, and the different interoperability reference architectures. We work on the architecture evolution cycles and help the public organization with some first steps guidelines, like answering the typical question, how do we start? Okay, about the community. In the past, we have run some workshops, webinars, and training courses on enterprise architecture, and especially about TOGAF standards. We see attendees motivated by the initiative and felt that they could apply the knowledge in the organization, but then we saw that the issue didn't work. They also felt distant of us to ask for help or some guidance. So we realized that the real value was in the discussion and knowledge sharing that can be, we can have within the government And we had this kind of discussion in the workshops, and they were enough, but then we lost. So we want to build a direct channel with our colleagues. In this way, the last year we create the architecture community inside the government. We had 3 meetings with people from 10 different public organizations. And this year we are going to have monthly meetings where we discuss different topics. Fortunately, we find new collaborators and new speakers and reference in our public agencies, and we find space to engage more people with this topic. And finally, our next steps are work with more integrated reference architecture. As I said before, we are working with the education reference architecture. We want to have a similar to e-health national records reference architecture. And we also are working with digital document administrative management that are legal processes inside the government, like digital files or digital notification for citizens and business. We also want to adopt agile methodologies in the enterprise architecture development. We want to merge these 2 different worlds that we are working to. I'm very glad to listen to the previous presentations about agile and digital. In one side, we have the enterprise architecture, and on the other side, we have the DevSecOps and DevOps culture change and the Scrum methodologies that we are applying in the IT projects. And we think they can be combined to get a better result of the world. The TOGAF and the enterprise architecture can be used to have a complete vision of the organization and to analyze the impact of each in each domain of new solutions or requirements. And then an agile methodology can be used to execute a project to achieve the target architecture with a better time-to-market solution and a user center that, in our case, are the citizens. Luckily, the Open Group has published last year a draft of the Agile Architecture Framework standard that we are studying and trying to learn from it. So this is our experience. I was a bit quickly, don't be late with our agenda.
Thank you very much, Juan. Thank you very much indeed. That's quite a project that's going on there, and good to see the progress so far, and be interesting at some point to hear how it goes along the way as well. So a big virtual round of applause, please, for Juan.